Hello everybody! Today we will learn the key takeaways and actionable steps from the book's Algorithm to Live by Brian Christian and Tom Griffiths.
In 2016, a programmer, Brian Christian, collaborated with a professor of psychology and cognitive science, Tom Griffiths, on this book, where they use insights from computer algorithms and find ways to apply them in our everyday lives, helping to solve common decision-making problems. An algorithm in mathematics and computer science is a finite sequence of well-defined steps to solve problems.
Key takeaways. Optimal stopping. When you're hiring an employee, scouting houses to buy or making a choice between different options, at what point should you stop looking if you cannot return to previous options?
If you stop looking too early, you may miss out on a better candidate. If you stop too late, you might have already passed on the best candidate. Mathematically, you should evaluate 37% of all the options you're willing to look into, with no intention to select any of them. After that point, if something else comes along that is better than anything else, you should make the decision immediately. For example, if you want to hire a secretary and you have 40 candidates, you should interview the first 15, with no intention to hire any of them. Then continue interviewing, and when you find a better secretary than of the 15 you initially interviewed, stop in instance and hire her. Or if you have a time window of 20 weeks to find your dream home, spend the first 7 weeks looking around houses without buying, and after that period, when you find a house which is better than the houses prior to that, close the deal. This is called the 37% rule. Note that this rule applies when you cannot return to previous options.
Exploration, exploitation.
When should you be exploring new options and when should you start settling for the best option you already know? It depends on how long you plan to enjoy them. At the beginning, we explore and in the end, we enjoy our best options. For example, if we go on holidays in a new city for a week, the first days we explore in order to know which are the best options to go to, restaurants to eat, and new ways to have fun. The last days of our stay, we revisit our favorite findings to exploit them and enjoy them even more.
When we short things, scale hurts. If we increase the quantity of things to be sorted, the time increases exponentially.
That's why, if you have to short stuff, do it regularly. For example, do your laundry often. It's easier to put one piece of clothing to the right place than to sort your entire wardrobe. The fastest method of sorting is the bucket sort method, a sorting algorithm that works by distributing the elements into a number of buckets. Each bucket is then sorted individually until the data is sorted. So, if you want to sort out your stuff, put them first in categories and continue from there with the same logic. Do not sort something you will not look for. Sort only when you will need to search in future repeatedly, and the sorting time has less value than the searching time. Sometimes it's okay to be messy. Ordering your bookshelf will take more time and energy than scanning through it. Caching. The most efficient forms of storage have cache for information or things that are used more recently or frequently. In computers, there's a cache memory that stores data that is used more recently or frequently, so that future requests for that data can be served faster. We can implement this to our lives by keeping things we often need close and move whatever hasn't been used recently to long-term storage. For example, rather than remembering every recipe when trying to decide what to make for lunch, keep notes of your favorite recipes or one you read about recently and wanted to try. Use a clothes stand for temporary storage of clothes. Items should be stored near the site where they are used.
Scheduling. Every day we are bombarded by a huge number of trivial tasks, so the important things are lost in the chaos. Which is the best way to organize our schedule?
You do not need a calendar, but a to-do list. Divide the importance of each task by the time required to complete it, and then perform the tasks in order of the task most important per unit time. Don't make the list too long. If a task requires less than 2 minutes, do it immediately. Also, set a minimum amount of time that will be devoted to a task. Don't switch your focus between tasks, because if the flow of thought is constantly interrupted, it can't produce meaningful work. Say no to distractions.
If we include more factors in a prediction model, it does not necessarily mean that it will make better forecasts, because we usually add more noise to the data.
Keep only the important factors and validate if the model makes predictions with data it has not yet been seen. Trying to predict a stock price, we will do it a better job if we focus only on the key fundamental indexes out of a company, such as earning, debt, and dividends, and not on a thousand arbitrary factors, news, and trends. Less is more.
The power of relaxation.
When we try to find the perfect solution, sometimes it is impossible, because some problems are too complex. What we can do, then, is relax the constraints on the problem. This leads to solutions which are good enough. Not all the rules are mandatory. You can insert the penalties for not obeying the rules in the solution and check the final score. For example, if you have 3 business appointments in one evening and you have to return a book to the library because it is its due day, it is impossible to do them all on time. So, you can go to the appointments and pay the fee to the library the following day. In the end, you will be better off.
Randomness can be used to test theories for probable accuracy, or can be used to optimize systems by trying all possibilities rather than only the most obvious ones.
Go to parties, read new books, or subscribe to this channel. They expose you to new unknown things that may benefit you. Randomness is an important factor to evolution.
Networking. Communication over a network is possible because each party must acknowledge the other's message and follow specific rules to avoid conflicting signals.
When we communicate with people, one useful algorithm is exponential retreat. After each message failure, double the time until the next broadcast. This is a solution to the problem of when to stop inviting an old friend that constantly says he's busy. Give a finite number of consecutive opportunities, double the interval between requests, and then completely rule out. After the initial invitation, try again in 1 week. After that, in 2 weeks. After that, 4 weeks. And it goes on until you stop after a certain number.
How I rate this book? Readability, 3 stars. Knowledge, 4 stars. Practicality, 5 stars. Overall, 4 stars. Those were the key takeaways from the books Algorithms to Live by Brian Christian and Tom Griffiths. If you like the content of this channel and you want more practical videos, don't forget to like and subscribe. Thank you.